Clenching back.
We're recording. Yeah, we're recording.
We're recording.
I was supposed to clap. I'm sorry. Like, we
okay.
Are so crazy.
Hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Y'all believe we're in December? I mean, I can't believe we're in December. I feel like I'm still in the same clothes from March. Like, quite literally, I think that I had on the same sweatpants. I feel like if I go back to videos in the beginning of when I did this thing, I had the same clothes on. So in one of my previous videos, I did a job spotlight with my friend Khadija, where she showed me how to apply everyday makeup. And so what I'm going to attempt to do today is take the tips that she showed me and try to apply my own makeup. So usually when I'm doing these things, and usually when I go out, all I do, like I said in that video, is I apply foundation and a lip and eyeliner. But I don't do like eyelashes. I don't know how to contour. I don't know how to do any of that stuff. So this is gonna be like Bailey Sarian. I hope I'm saying her name right. I hope that I can body it like how she bodies it. Y'all watch her makeup and murder mysteries. If you've never watched her makeup and murder mysteries, I think it's every Monday that she posts it on her YouTube. It is, I'm a mystery, like ID channel is my thing. My favorite podcast used to be My Favorite Murder. So this is like on the same lines as that. And she's doing makeup. So I'm trying to implement what Khadija taught me and watching Bailey, all while giving you guys tips on how to explain your employment gap on your resume and in interviews. So here we go. In my explanation today, I have three major tips on how to explain your gaps of employment, whether it be in your resume or in the interview. I don't know if you're supposed to do this, but I'm cleaning my face with makeup remover. I don't know if that's the thing. The way that Bailey does it, her stuff is like right over and I'm like doing a one-off thing, so my bad. I'm trying out new things because I'm trying to see what sticks, you know? So anyway, my top... Come on in! So before I get started, y'all, my next door neighbor just walked in. Hey, boo! You look so cute! Yes.
How are you? Coming over to say hello.
All dressed up and dolled up.
I just came back from the store.
Oh, okay. This is Tiff.
Hi.
So I'm going to school you real quick on recording.
Okay, so we had to change angles since Miss Tiff came upstairs. We had to rearrange some things. So this is Tiffany. She's my, not only is she my next door neighbor, before my wedding, she did my hair, my makeup, my cake, my cupcakes for the reception, my cookies for the reception. Oh, my cupcakes for the wedding too.
Yeah.
Forgot. Tell the people a little bit about your tasty treats.
I have a company called A Taste of Heaven, and I also have Tasty Treats by Tiff. Got into culinary school and just fell in love with baking, so I do anything from cakes to cookies to savory dishes to just about anything you want, I can do it for you when it comes to cooking.
And makeup. So it's ironic that you came today because...
What is the special?
You saw my video with Khadija where Khadija showed me how to do my own makeup on camera.
Yes, yes, okay. Yes.
So I am going to attempt to take what she taught me with the makeup that you helped me buy. Tiff helped me buy this makeup for my wedding. With the makeup that you helped me buy.
Okay.
on myself.
This is perfect. Came on the right time. You know what I'm saying? Right time.
And Tiff is the contour queen. So we'll see how.
You can do it. She can do it.
Okay. If you are questioning what's in our wine glasses right now, because this is not the typical wine color, I am doing a 30-day challenge where I am not drinking until December 30th. And Tiff is oh so kind to not drink with me, at least tonight.
Yes, at least tonight. It's tonight. Tomorrow's a different story.
So this is apple cider. Cheers.
Cheers.
For gaps in your employment, my very first tip is... My very first tip is to change your mindset.
Okay.
So a lot of times people think that a gap in the employment is a negative thing. Okay. It's not a negative thing. It's only a negative thing if you think that it is a negative thing.
You know, it's weird that I have a gap in my corporate resume.
Uh-huh.
So this is like great. I'm like perfect timing. Because getting back into the work field, if I were to get back into the work field, definitely... I would be self-conscious because I have a huge gap in my employment in the corporate world.
Mm-hmm.
So it definitely would make someone self-conscious.
Yeah, you don't want to be, because what happens is when you look at it negatively, that comes across in the interview and nobody's going to want to hire you because you're not confident and you're not, fumbling over, you know, why you're... gap it, like, you know, the reasoning for your gap.
Mm-hmm.
Do you watch Makeup and Murder Mysteries by Bailey Sarian?
No, I don't.
It's on YouTube. And what she does is she talks about murders while doing her makeup.
What?
Yes.
Oh, I gotta look that up.
She talks about murders while doing her makeup. And she makes it look so easy. But this is hard talking...
Talking and doing your makeup?
Yeah!
Yes. Some have to concentrate.
So, yes, you need to change your mindset. That's my tip number one. Change your mindset. Mm-hmm. You don't want to look at your gaps negatively because it's going to come across that way.
Okay.
My tip number two is change your resume format. So, normally resume formats are chronological and it goes by your work history.
Yes.
That's so 1990s. You don't need to do that.
Okay. That's what I thought you were supposed to do, but okay.
No.
Bring me up to date. Bring me up to date.
That's the old school. That's your mama's resume, okay?
Yes.
You don't need to do that.
Okay.
Can I put more foundation on?
You sure can, honey. This is your face. You do what you want.
Okay. I probably am not supposed to do this, right?
Teachers don't, you know.
Okay.
As long as it goes on smooth, that's the end goal.
The format that I would recommend using is the functional resume format. And I talked about this in a previous Reading Corner, which I'll tag up below, over there somewhere. The functional resume format focuses on your skills and what you have previously accomplished in a previous role.
Okay.
So, like, it will focus on, you know, if you've boosted sales at your previous company or, like, the different skills that you developed will be forefront on your resume. You can choose if you want to include your work history at the end of your resume. Sometimes I do. Sometimes I'll put it, like, if I'm redoing someone's resume, I'll put the work history underneath. But if you're really self-conscious about your gap in employment, functional resume format.
That is bomb. I never knew that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm, like, back in the 1980s with the resume.
I wish that LinkedIn would come up to speed. LinkedIn does the chronological order, so... If you're still using LinkedIn to apply for jobs, which I highly recommend using LinkedIn to apply to jobs. If you're still using LinkedIn to apply to jobs, you're going to have to do the
chronological.
There we go. You're going to have to use that format if you're using LinkedIn. Mm-hmm. But for your regular resume, I will still make that a functional resume and send that out to recruiters.
Yeah, that's really good to know. I never knew that. At all. I just thought it was one way. That's it. No other way to do it. I think that's better too. That would make me feel more comfortable.
How do I look?
Good.
See, and this is usually where I stop. So I usually stop.
That's it. Cut.
I usually stop at the foundation and I'm put on some eyeliner if I'm feeling fancy.
Fancy. Mm-hmm.
And then I put on a little lip.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so for Tiff's birthday dinner, we went to, where did we go for your birthday?
Ruth's Chris.
Yes. We went to Ruth's Chris for Tiff's birthday dinner. Mm-hmm. And this is all I did.
But she's still cute. Like.
But look at her.
Okay, so what you want to do is you want to basically you want to bring whatever you highlight, which is that lighten up, you're bringing it out. So what I do is you take it and you go droop down all the way down the nose, even on some on the nostril.
Switched up our angles for the third time, yeah. So that I can look in the mirror and look at you guys at the same time, kind of like what I was saying in the beginning. So before you walked in, mm-hmm. I was saying that I needed a setup like this, and see, I needed a third person, whatever. I needed a second person here to help me because I couldn't figure out. Y'all need to see how crazy. Anyway,
so well, I imagine y'all could see it's good.
Yes. And hopefully y'all can see me better now.
Yes, we can see the contour.
All right, so I blended in. Is that the right word?
Yes.
Blended. Mm-hmm. I blended in my chin. And now I'm going to blend in my nose first?
Or yeah,
my,
just whatever. Here? Yeah, I just want to blend everything in.
I feel like I'm beating my gums.
That's what it's going to feel like, girl. It's going to feel like you've been in a fight, but it's okay. As long as that face look pretty.
So once you change your mindset and mm-hmm. once you change your resume, you're putting your resume out there, you're applying to gigs, you get a phone call from a recruiter mm-hmm. or you get your interview and they say, explain mm-hmm. why you haven't been working for the past 2 years.
Yes, that's what I was going to ask you about that. Like what mm-hmm. happens if they ask you, why haven't you worked? Like what will be the appropriate answer?
None of your business. Second tip. That's not. Don't do that. Don't do that.
No, not appropriate.
First tip when they ask you in an interview mm-hmm. is to be honest, but be brief. Okay. Don't go too personal. Like if you became a mother and mm-hmm. you took a couple of years off and you're just trying to get back into the workforce, mm-hmm. don't go into, well, you know, I was pregnant for 9 months and then I gave birth to, you know, the this beautiful brown human being. And do you want to see pictures?
That's me.
Yeah. Don't do all that. First tip is to be short and brief.
Okay.
Honest, but be brief. The second tip is to just make sure that they know it's not a problem.
Gotcha. Okay.
So, like, you know, if you're just coming off of a break mm-hmm. and, you know, you're looking for employment, just let them know, like, yeah. Yes, you know, I took time out for my family, but that's not going to be an issue. You know, I'm 100% committed to becoming a great value add to a team. Okay, I look real smooth.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
You don't want something here with this tree of life.
That's exactly what it looks like, a tree.
So you want to be brief. You want to bring it right back to, you know, why you're looking for a job.
Mm-hmm.
And then my third tip is to not gloss over the gap in employment, but mm-hmm. you want, again, kind of like your resume,
okay.
you want to hone in on the skills that you have learned.
Okay.
And tie it back into the job that you're applying to. Even if you have this large gap, you still mm-hmm. learn something in your gap. So let's hypothetically say, like, you know, your dad, let's say that mm-hmm. you took some time off, not to go into all of Tiff's stuff, but Tiff's father had some medical stuff that just recently happened.
Yes.
And so let's say that you had to take some time off mm-hmm. to take care of your dad. So you. Guys.
Hello.
All right. So We talked for a whole 30, 40 minutes.
Yeah.
Put on some other thing of makeup, and my phone just, yeah, it went to the home screen.
Yeah.
And
in the midst of us talking.
Yeah. So
I'll go back over the tips just for you.
Yes, just for you. We're going to go back over the tips. And Tiff asked an excellent question. Yes. And I hope she remembers her question because
I do.
We're going to have to ask that again.
Okay.
And
replay. This would not have happened if she would have had a good old Android. Okay? We lost everything.
We didn't lose everything. Okay, just 30 minutes. It's fine. And your phone's dead. So
I just forgot my charger. It's still a good phone.
I forgot to tell them to subscribe to my video, so you're gonna help
oh,
me.
Oh, yeah.
I need you to stop what you're doing.
Stop.
Right now.
Right now.
Hit the subscribe button.
Hit that red button.
Hit the alert button.
Hit that bell.
So that you can be alerted to other videos like this one. Mm-hmm. I post every Friday.
Consistency is everything.
Oh, but I wasn't consistent last week, Tiff.
Take that out.
She's throwing me out there. Anyway. I provide you with different types of tips and different stories. I have guest appearances sometimes. Yeah. If you have recommendations on something that you would like to see, leave that comment below.
Right down here. Mm-hmm. Bam.
So now we are on to eyebrows.
Yes, we're going to do some good old eyebrows. Can't do a face without the eyebrows.
Okay. you know, I'm about to tell Tiff to do it for me, but I'm trying to commit to this and doing it myself thing.
I know okay. That's right.
I go like this.
Okay, so, oh, you're holding this the wrong way. Yep, just like, oh,
like this?
Flat. Mm-hmm. So you want to go right underneath your eyebrow.
I want my eyebrow. You do it, Tiff.
Thank you. I'll do this.
See? You see what happens? I was doing fine without these drawn-on eyebrows. I hate the way drawn-on eyebrows look.
Oh, my gosh. Just don't move your eyebrow.
But I talk.
No moving.
Tiff, didn't your dad just recently have, like, medical...
Yes, he had a medical issue that I had to take care of him.
Yeah.
So... I guess that's the way I can tie that in.
Right. So if Tiff is trying to get back into the workforce, which Tiff is not because she is an excellent entrepreneur, but if Tiff was trying to get back into the workforce, she could use the skills from taking care of her father to be applicable to the job that she's applying to. Any position, a core skill is to be able to work with others. And to be able to, you know, work in a team setting, especially in a managerial role, there needs to be some sort of compassion for others. And so Tiff could use that. You could state, you know, while taking care of my father, I learned. This is a lot better than this one.
Yeah, you kind of came on a little strong. No, you came on a little strong underneath the eyebrow, but you know, I was trying to.
Oh!
You came on a little strong, but it's okay, you know? As long
as you're. Yeah, this is a lot better than this one. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what I did.
You just went a little too dark, and I'm just trying to.
I didn't lie. You told me.
No, that was a little dark, and it was underneath the brow. Not
you
right
told
at the
me underneath.
Right at the hairline, right at the bottom of the hairline. But it's okay. We can always correct it. That's the point of makeup.
You can use the skill set of taking care of your family, of especially the analogy that I love to use is housewives, right? Mm-hmm. Like if you were at home taking care of the house, taking care of the family, and then you decide to jump back into the workforce, being a stay-at-home mom, that is project management one-on-one.
Multitasking,
taking care of everything,
giving out orders, make sure everyone's in check.
Yes.
Schedule.
Routine. You can use that as like, you know, say, there's an actual name for housewife. It's like social engineering or something. Ooh. I've got to. But anyway, there's ways of spinning how.
Would you look at a negative into a positive?
Yes. If you want help with your gap.
Mm-hmm. Mo's your girl. Mo is your girl. She'll have her information in the link.
In the link and down below.
Yeah, down below. That's what I mean. Down below.
Yes. I can help you. But now they don't look even.
Mo, just
Do they look even?
No, don't.
She got me looking crazy.
I can't see the thing on my other
way. You know, during the video that I had with Khadijah, we was caught up on these dang eyebrows.
Eyebrows can make or break. Like I said, it can make or break somebody. This one looks good, right? Right, guys? This one. You know, she went a little rough. So I have a question. So say, for instance, you have a felony. How do you tell your job that? Do you tell the job that you're interviewing that? Like, how does that come into play?
Good question.
Okay.
If your gap in employment is because you had some jail time or you had some legal issues, there's a fine time that I will recommend telling them.
Okay.
I will recommend telling them after, in between the we're really interested in you and there's a background check. What you don't want to happen is for them to find out during the background check.
Okay.
Because then it almost feels like you're omitting detail. You're like leaving something out and that's like never a good look. Yes. Okay. Yes. And sometimes it comes across better if you explain it than them reading something.
Yeah,
because it might not be as big as, you know, what they're reading in black and white. So I always recommend, if you know for a fact that the job is going to do a background check, then I would recommend telling them.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. Before the background check happens or occurs.
Okay, so the reason for my question is because I know someone who went on an interview, aced the interview, they loved him, and when they said he was hired, everything, they had to do a background check on him, and when they did the background check, it came up that something was a little, had a felony, in his background, so then they said they couldn't hire him.
Yeah, I think that he should have been honest up front, like right before they did the background check. Now, just because you're honest doesn't mean that
They're going to hire you,
but at least it saves them from doing the background check.
Because he marked that he had a felony on the application, but I guess they just didn't ask for details when he was in there. So I guess when they looked at it, they were like,
Especially when they just see it for the first time, when they're pulling up the record, when you explain it, I think that
it won't sound as bad.
Right, it won't sound as bad, and they'll understand it. They'll be able to ask you questions.
Should you put in a cover letter, explain something like that in a cover letter, or no? That's best explained.
The only reason why I would put it on a cover letter is if it is specific to the job. And so I bring up the like driver. You have a CDL license and you're applying for a driving position, but whatever felony or whatever legal thing happens, you lost your license, but you only lost your license for a specific amount of time. I will put that on the cover letter, like explain why you don't have your license at the current moment, but you will at X, Y, and Z date, which is perfect timing for whatever the job is, because you still need to find a job while you're so that something like that will be really the only reason why I will put it on the cover letter. But honesty is the best policy. I think we learned that in elementary school.
Yes.
So if you had a felony or something, I would say tell right before they do it. Yep, right before they do a background check. And, you know, if they really want you, it won't matter.
Yes.
It really doesn't matter.
The flip side to the story is that he ended up going somewhere else and they ended up liking him so much. He wasn't even there for an interview or nothing, but he needed his hours. So he ended up going somewhere else, and they actually ended up hiring him right on the spot because they loved him so much. He ended up being top in the company. See? Also, the job that turned him down before wanted him back. Come on back. He said, see? No, I'm good where I'm at.
I'm good.
Now, you know, he has his own business and stuff, so, you know, but...
Say that part again. He has his own business
now. You know? So when one door closes, another one opens to greatness.
This is the grand tip right here, okay? If you are really concerned, truly concerned with your gap in employment, to the point where you haven't changed your mind frame about it, you don't like how the functional resume looks, you aren't confident enough to talk about it in the interview, start your own business.
Bam. You don't have to ask nobody nothing, tell nobody nothing. Nope. You the boss.
Don't got to explain to anybody.
Exactly. That's what counts. You know, you have to be your own boss. So then, you know, you don't have to answer these questions, especially when people keep shutting the doors. People want to want you back.
Yep.
It's like, nope, I got my own thing going. Thank you, though.
And now we're done. All right.
No. Listen, you have what's three next? Sticks for a reason, honey.
We didn't go through three?
No, we only went through two. Which one did we go through?
We've been here all night, y'all. We've been here all night. So we've reached the end of my tips for how to explain your gaps of employment within your resume and within an interview. So Tiff is going to finish my face because obviously I can't do it.
She did a bomb job though.
I can't do bomb. It. We'll be right back.
Wipe. Hi.
All right. So Tiff finished my face because I don't know how to do all of this. And I feel like a bald head scallywag and got no hair in back because I don't got no lashes. And see, I feel like the more you cake on, the more you have to add because these eyebrows go with lashes.
Yeah. She doesn't have any eyelash mascara. But it's cool. You know, this is just for the video. The main thing is the contouring. We just tried to do a little something, you know. She's going to step her makeup game up, right? Yeah. Get a little bit more makeup. Just have fun, you know, colors, all that kind of great.
So, I think that I might stop at the contour thing. I don't know about the eyebrows.
Yeah, just a little bit. I think I might pencil will probably be easier versus maybe the.
Okay. Yeah, because I think Khadija showed me on a pencil. So anyway, I hope that you took away some great makeup tips today. I also hope that you took away some great tips on how to cover your gap of employment within your resume within an interview. Please like, comment, and share.
Yes.
If you share, you think I should do it too?
I think you should. I think they deserve it.
You think so?
I think so.
Okay. If you share this, please, not if. When you share this video.
How many people should they share to?
Everybody. Everybody la-di-da-di, but just share it. Put it on your LinkedIn page, put it on your Facebook page, put it on your Instagram page, your Instagram story.
Yes.
Repost it. Whenever you repost it, reshare it, put it up on anything, tag me. Because what I'm going to do is I'm giving away a free complete resume do-over with a LinkedIn page.
What?
I'm going to pick one person from the group of people because it's going to be groups of people.
It's going to be groups of people.
I'm going to pick one person out of the group of people who shared this and tagged me. So you have to make sure you tag me. Thank you for tuning in. I will see you next week. Tiff might be back with me next week. I like doing this with Tiff.
Yeah, you know, right by street, easy. You know what I'm saying?
Maybe next week we can talk about being entrepreneurs.
Yes. That would be great. That would be great.
Because Tiff has a ton of different streams of income and she don't even advertise.
No.
She doesn't need to. That's what I'm saying. Like, because all the words, she's always over there making a cake. I'm always over there getting shaving.
The measly. She gets the measly.
The measly. All right. So we'll talk to you guys next week.
It was fun. Thanks. Bye.